such a freedom I have found in you. You're the healer who makes all things new. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Not going back, I'm moving ahead. I'm here to declare to you, my past is over in you. Things are made.
Single belief calls us together as a community and sends us into our world with hope and purpose. At our church, your past will never define your future. There's always redemption, which means there's always a brighter day. At our church, we don't think we're better than any other church out there. We're just doing our best to become our best. At our church, we want you to believe in God, but we also want you to know that God believes in you. We are not against people who don't attend church anywhere. Instead, we pursue them with love, the very same love that's pursuing us. At our church, we're learning to serve God with all our hearts, and we're learning to worship Him with all our lives. And if you're looking for the perfect church, we're not it. At our church, we will make mistakes, but we will choose to grow from them. At our church, we're part of a global community that's knit together by the resurrection of Jesus. And by the way, at our church, we believe that really happened too. At our church, we will engage with people who are in real need because we are the hands and the feet of Christ. And finally, we need you to hear this loud and clear. At our church, it's not really our church at all. It's His. And we live and move and breathe in His church for His glory and His fame, not ours. So here's the invitation. You're invited to jump in with your whole heart at your own pace and to experience the life that awaits you in Christ. Friends, this is going to be good. Welcome to our church.
Amen. Good morning, city. How are we? Oh, it's dark and dreary, but we're going to praise Him today. Amen. Today's scripture reading is coming from Mark chapter 10. I'm going to begin reading at verse 6 down through verse 9. And it reads, "But from the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother and cleave to his wife, and they twain shall be one flesh. So then they are more than twain, but one flesh. But whatever God hath joined together, let no man put asunder." Amen. The word of the Lord is already blessed. Let us pray. God, we thank You for this time of coming together to worship and magnify Your name. God, we pray that Your Spirit would be in the midst of this place even right now. God, let Your power just overtake this room. God, let Your power just take over us. God, we pray even in the midst of worship that Your Spirit would take over this place, God. God, we pray that You would calm all minds. God, calm all spirits. God, put our mindset on You. Put our mindset on worship. God, we came here today to lift up and magnify Your name. We came today to glorify and magnify You. God, it's all about You today, not about us. So, God, take our minds off of anything that's not about You. God, all of our problems, we put them away, God. All of those negative thoughts, we put those things away. Everything that makes us nervous, anything that makes us upset, God, we put it away right now in the name of Jesus. What someone said to us before service means nothing. We came today to give You the praise. God, we came to glorify You and came to lift You up. We came to magnify You and give You all the praise because that's what You're worthy of. God, we thank You for everything that You've done for us on this week. Sometimes we complain, but God, we thank You because You woke us up. God, You started us on our way. God, You gave us food to eat and clothes on our backs. God, You gave us a way to work. God, You gave us the job that we have. And God, we thank You and we praise You because we may not like everything in our life, but God, You made our life. So God, we thank You for everything that You've done. And God, we pray in the name of Jesus that You would be glorified on today, that You would be uplifted on today. Thank You for those builders who are here right now. God, we pray for strength and power over their lives right now in the name of Jesus. Thank You for the builders who are on the way, not just on the way today, but who are on the way for the next year, for the next month, for the next few years. God, we thank You for them in advance before they're even here because we know they're on the way. God, we bless You and we magnify You and we glorify You and we lift You up. Be glorified in this service. God, get the glory on today. In Jesus' name we pray. Somebody say amen. Amen. Let us all stand. Come on, clap your hands. Come on.
And the people of God sing it. And the people of God sing it. And the people of God sing it.
And the people of God sing it.
Come on, clap your hands right here. Come on, come on. Oh God, we bless You and we magnify Your name today. And we give You all the praise. Oh God, because You're worthy. Hallelujah, Jesus. Come on, you know the song. Say this.
This is the day.
This is the day.
This is the day
that the Lord has made.
The Lord has made.
Mercy.
The Lord has
Come on,
made.
Tell Him I will rejoice.
I will rejoice.
Come on, I will rejoice.
I will rejoice.
Let me glad in. Come on and say glad in.
Glad in.
Come on, say
this is the day.
That we serve is awesome and worthy to be praised. Hallelujah to his name. God, we bless you. For this is the day that the Lord has made. Hallelujah. If you know God is good and worthy of the praise, somebody just say hallelujah to his name. Come on. If you know God is good, come on right here. The song says that the Lord is high above the heavens. Oh, hallelujah. And his glory above the nations. Oh, we give him praise. Come on, get a little rock with it. Come on. Yeah. Sing this with me.
The Lord is high above the heavens.
The Lord is high above the heavens.
And his glory above the nations.
And his glory above the nations.
Come on, the Lord is high above the heavens.
The Lord is high above the heavens.
And his glory above the nation.
And his glory above
come
the nation.
Come on, the Lord is high above.
The Lord is high above the
heaven. And his glory above the nation.
And his glory above
come
the nation.
Come on, the Lord is high above the heaven.
The Lord is high above the heaven.
And his glory above the nation.
And his glory come above on. The nation.
We give God the highest praise, acknowledging him always. And all the people sing hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Sing hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Come on, y'all got about that.
The Lord is high above the heaven.
The Lord is high above the heaven.
If you believe that, clap your hands right here. Hallelujah.
And his glory above the nation.
And his glory above the nation.
Oh, I love it, I love it, I love it. Come on and say,
the Lord is high above the heaven.
The Lord is high above the heaven.
Oh, we give him praise and glory. Yeah, because he's worthy. Hallelujah.
And his glory above the nation.
And his glory above the nation.
Hallelujah. Come on. You know the next part.
We give God the highest praise today in the city. Yeah. We give your name the praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Say hallelujah. Yeah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Oh, come on. Sing hallelujah.
Come on, see it.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Come on, sing hallelujah.
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 worthy. Clap your hands right here. Come on. Come on. Come on. The God that I serve is awesome. Somebody just say hallelujah, Jesus. Somebody say hallelujah, Jesus. God, you're worthy of all the praise, all the honor, and all the glory. Hallelujah. Come on, if you know he's worthy, just say hallelujah. Yeah, we bless your name, and we give you all the praise, Jesus, because you're awesome. And worthy of all the praise. Hallelujah, Jesus. How many know Jesus will? I love it. Come on. I felt it in my spirit. Come on, say who?
Hope in store.
That eyes. Come on.
That I
cannot see.
Cannot see.
Yeah. See Jesus will.
Jesus will. Jesus,
oh, come on, y'all. I felt that thing in my spirit. Hallelujah. Come on, say, who
will make all
my decisions with me?
My
you want to make it with me? See, Jesus will.
Jesus will.
My Jesus will. Yeah, I love it. I love it. I like this part. See, when I'm in trouble. Come on, say, he gives me a song.
He gives
me a song. Somebody said, that's the peace that surpasses all understanding in the night season.
In the night season.
And all the day long.
And all
the day long.
The day long.
Yes, he will. See, who makes me do right, yeah.
Who makes me do
what
right.
I want to do wrong. Thing in my spirit. Come on and tell it. See, when I'm in trouble.
When I'm in trouble.
Come on, say he gives me a song.
He gives
me a song.
Me a song.
Hallelujah, Jesus. And in the night season, yeah,
in
yeah,
the
yeah.
Night
come on and say all the day long.
And all
the day long.
The day long.
Yes, you do, Jesus. And you make me do right, yeah.
When
I want to do wrong,
when
I want to
do wrong,
see Jesus will. I know he will,
Jesus
yeah,
yeah.
I don't know if y'all ready for this. See,
yeah,
Jesus will.
Jesus will.
I know he will because he said he will.
Today.
I know he will.
I know that he will.
Come on.
Jesus, my Jesus.
Jesus will.
I know he will.
I know he will.
Yes, I do.
I know he will.
I know that he will.
Come on. I need you to get it in your spirit. Say,
I know that he will.
Yeah. I know Jesus will. Yeah.
I know that he will.
Let's come out right here. See, Jesus will. Yeah.
Jesus will.
How many of you know he will? How many of you know he will? How many of you know he will? Somebody say Jesus will. Somebody say Jesus will. Somebody say Jesus will. Somebody say Jesus will. Yes, he will. Right here, I want you to shift into a worship. When you think about the goodness of Jesus and all that he's done for you, your soul should cry out hallelujah to his name. He will sit down for glory.
Sit down for glory.
Come on, say many things.
Many things you were.
A holy king.
A holy king.
A carpenter.
A carpenter.
Come on, tell him you.
You are the living one.
Sing Jesus, Jesus.
Lord of heaven.
Sit down for glory.
Sit down for glory.
Sing many things.
Many things you are.
Come on, a holy king.
A holy king.
A carpenter.
A carpenter.
Come on, say you.
You are the living
God. Awesome ruler.
Awesome ruler.
A gentle redeemer.
Gentle redeemer.
Come on. Sing God with us. And what a friend, and what a friend. Come on, say you.
Awesome ruler.
You're a gentle redeemer. God with us, yes.
The living truth.
And what a friend, and what a friend we have in you.
Come on, say you.
I like that. Sing Jesus, Jesus.
Jesus, Jesus.
That's what we call
That's
you.
What we call you.
Born in the manger.
Manger boy, God honors you.
You
died to save humanity.
Oh, I love it. Sing you.
You are the living
Jesus,
one.
Jesus, Jesus.
Jesus, Jesus.
That's what we call
That's
you.
What we call you.
You were born in a manger.
Manger boy, God honors you. You died to save humanity.
Come on, sing you.
You are the living
Let's take
word.
It up. Sing Jesus, Jesus.
Jesus, Jesus.
That's what we call
That's
you.
That's what we call you.
You were born.
Oh,
mouth. Somebody say hallelujah, Jesus. Somebody say hallelujah, Jesus. God, we bless you. Come on, let's lift him up. Hallelujah, Jesus. Bless your name, Father. 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 Bless your name. Come on, turn up your worship. Come on, come on, come on. We're not leaving this place until we break through something. Come on, somebody came in today needing a breakthrough from the Father. On today, you're going to get it in praise and worship. I'm not going to have to preach a breakthrough to you. You're going to worship your way into a breakthrough. I dare you to open up your mouth and say, thank you, Jesus. Yeah. We bless your name, Jesus. Yeah. This is our prayer, that he would open up the floodgates of heaven and pour us out a blessing, yes. And pour us out a blessing, yes, yes. If you know he's worthy, open up your mouth and say, open.
Open the floodgates of heaven.
The floodgates of heaven, yes, and let it rain.
Let it rain.
I came today to give your name the praise, yes, Jesus.
Let it rain.
I believe if we would open
the floodgates,
and give him praise, and he will open up the floodgates of heaven, yes, and rain down a blessing. And rain down a blessing. Lift your voice and say, open.
Open the floodgates of heaven.
Come on, I hear you, city. Say, let it rain.
Let it rain.
Come on, in the sanctuary, we want you to.
Let it rain.
Come on, I'll sing the track. Come on and sing, open the floodgates.
Open the floodgates of heaven.
Rain down the blessing, Jesus.
Let it rain.
Yeah, I feel it, I feel it. He's here, he's here. Come on, say let it.
Let it rain.
Yeah, if you need a blessing right there, come on and open up your mouth.
And so open the floodgates of heaven.
Come on and let it rain.
Right there, go in.
I feel the rain. I feel the rain, Jesus. I feel the rain. It's raining, yes. It's raining, yes. It's raining, yeah, yeah, yeah. Come on, Jesus, rain. It's raining, yes, it's raining, yes, it's raining, yes, it's raining, yes, it's raining, yes. Hey, I feel the rain, Jesus. I feel the rain. Does anybody need some rain? Does anybody need some rain? Oh, God, we bless your name. Jesus, rain down blessings, Jesus. I feel the rain, I feel the rain, I feel the rain, yeah.
Come on, come on, come on, open up your mouth.
See, yeah, 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 yeah. I feel the rain, yeah.
let it rain.
Somebody in here, you came today and you had a whole bunch of stuff on your plate, a whole bunch of things on your mind, a whole bunch of things in your spirit. God told me to tell you, if you would open up and worship him just a little bit more, give him just a little bit more, lift your hands just a little bit higher, open your mouth just a little bit wider, then he's going to begin to calm the storm in your life. Some of us go through things and we don't tell nobody what we're going through. Some of us worship through our pain. But I decree and I declare today, Jesus,
it's raining.
I decree and I declare
it's raining.
Over your finances today, it's raining.
It's raining.
Over your emotions today, it's raining, yes.
It's raining.
Yeah, you've got to open up your mouth and worship him if you want him to open the floodgates. Come on, I'm trying to get you to escape into a place of worship where his presence will change you, where his presence will fill you, where his presence will touch you. I dare you to say, I feel the rain. Oh, yes, I do. Open up. Open up. Open up. Come on and let it rain. Floodgates, yeah.
Open the floodgates of heaven.
Come on, let it rain, Jesus.
Let it rain.
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 Yes. Right here. He's worthy, yes. Wait a minute. Come on, hold on, hold on. Before you go to the next song, I need to hear you open up your mouth. Come on, come on. Open up your mouth. Come on, begin to worship him. Just say hallelujah. Come on, lift your voice. Say hallelujah, Jesus. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Y'all trying to get somewhere. Come on, come on. Hallelujah, Jesus. We bless your name, Father. Come on, he needs to hear a corporate worship. I need everybody in the house to just open up your mouth and say, thank you, Jesus. Come on, I'm going to break something in this spirit realm today. Hallelujah, Jesus. You will not leave the same way you came. Hallelujah, Jesus. Come on, open up your mouth. Come on, worshipers. You got to turn this thing up. Hallelujah, Jesus. God, we bless you and we magnify you and we glorify you and we give your name all the praise. God, break something in this room even right now. God, break something in this house even right now. God, break something in this house. Break the chains, Jesus. Break the chains, Jesus. Break the chains, Jesus. Break the chains in the name of Jesus. God, do it. God, do it right now, Father. Some of you got chains over your minds. I break them in the name of Jesus. Yes, Jesus. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, I'm trying to get us somewhere. Come on, come on, come on. Hallelujah, Jesus. God, we bless you. God, we magnify you. God, we glorify you. Come on. God, we lift you up. God, be glorified in this place. God, be magnified in this place. God, we love you. God, we bless you. God, we lift you up. Come on. Come on. If you're tired, you can sit down. But I need the worshipers to keep standing and keep giving him a true worship. Come on. Give him a true praise. Open up your mouth and say, thank you, Jesus. Yeah, God, we bless you. God, we magnify your name. God, we glorify your name. Hallelujah. Come on. Come on. I need to hear you. Come on. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. God, we bless your name. God, we glorify you. God, be lifted up in this place. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. God, we bless you. God, we magnify you. God, we glorify you. God, we lift you up. Hallelujah. Come on. Come on. Come on. I feel something in his presence. I believe he's going to do something great today. Come on, we got to work for it. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Yeah. 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 How many of you know that he could break every chain? I believe somebody needs to hear it. I believe somebody needs to hear it.
There is power.
You need to know.
In the name of Jesus.
Yeah, that's it right there.
There is power.
Yeah.
I
know this for somebody in the house. I felt it.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
Here's what the power of God will do.
To break every chain. Break every chain. Break every chain.
I dare you to give a broken chain worship.
Break every chain.
Over your mind.
Break every chain.
Over your finances.
Break every chain.
Yeah.
Come on, Tim, sing.
Yeah.
There is power.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I wish you would worship right here.
Oh, there is power.
Yeah.
In the name of Jesus.
Come on, worship breaks chains. Come on.
There is power.
Come on.
In the name of Jesus.
Worshipers, do me a favor. Walk this sanctuary. Walk this sanctuary. Come on, I need y'all to saturate this place. Come on. We're worshipers. Walk this sanctuary. Come on. Walk the entire sanctuary and just worship. Come on, grab the flags and wave the flags and worship. Come on. Come on, walk this entire place. Come on, I need you to saturate this place. The enemy's really trying to attack somebody today. I won't let it be. Come on, walk this place. You have the freedom to walk through this place and saturate it with worship. Do it right now. Hallelujah, Jesus. Come on and walk this place. Come on. With your hands lifted up, come on. With your mouth filled with praise, come on. Hallelujah, Jesus. Come on, we're going to break it today. Come on, we're going to break every chain today. We're going to break every chain today. We're going to break every chain today. To break every chain. Break every chain. We're breaking every chain, Jesus. Breaking every chain. Hallelujah. We break the chains. Yeah, come on. Come on, army. March the sanctuary. Turn it up a little bit. I need to hear it some more. Come on. Hallelujah. Yeah, that's it right there. Come on. If you're an army in the Lord, come on, say it.
There's an army rising up.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is. It's going
to break every chain.
Over your mind. Over your emotions. Hey God. Yes, God. We break every chain. We break every chain. Yeah. Come on, worship right there. Hallelujah. Yeah. I hear it, yeah. Yeah. If you have a need from the Lord, begin to ask it right now in worship. The Bible says, come before his presence with praise and thanksgiving. And then make your request known unto God. So what you need, I need you to ask for it right now. Come on and ask for it. If you need peace of mind, if you need a job, if you need God to move in some kind of way, I need you to ask for it right now. Yeah, the portal is open. The portal is open. And his spirit is here. Yeah, we made it, we made it, we made it. Yeah, thank you, Jesus. Rising up. Oh, it came to break every chain, Jesus. We believe it. We receive it.
Oh, God, you. God will, God will, yes he will, yes he will.
Come on, worship.
Come on, call it by its name. We come against the spirit of homosexuality. We come against the spirit of rejection and depression. Somebody release it into the atmosphere. And we declare that the chains be broken.
Yeah.
That the chains be broken. The
yeah.
Power of life and death.
Yeah. Yeah.
And you declare that the chains are broken.
Yeah. Yeah, I feel it. I feel it breaking. Yeah. Yeah.
The chains falling.
I dare you to say that right now in Jesus' name. Declare it.
I hear the chains falling. Yes, yes, I do, Jesus. Yes, I hear the chains falling.
Do you feel them? Do you hear them in the spirit?
I hear the chains. They're falling, yeah. I hear the chains.
I hear the chains falling. Yes, I do. Yes, I do. I feel them. I hear them in my spirit. Yes.
Oh, yeah. The chains. They're breaking off, yes.
Come on, let's worship right here. For just a few more seconds. Lift your hands. Yeah. Come on, let's praise him for broken chains. Yeah. I promise you, I feel the chains breaking. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you and we praise you and we magnify you for allowing your spirit to come into this place. God, we thank you and we praise you and we glorify God, we glorify your name and we give you all the praise. Thank you for broken chains. Thank you for broken chains. Come on, I need y'all to say that. Thank you for broken chains, Jesus. Thank you for broken chains. Come on. Thank you, Father. And God, we bless your name. And we give you all the praise. Hallelujah to your name, Jesus. Hallelujah to your name, Jesus. God, we bless you and God, we magnify you. Yeah, we're here. Hallelujah to your name, Jesus. Hallelujah to your name, Jesus. Come on, his spirit's here. Come on. Yeah. Thank you, Jesus. Bless your name, Father. Come on. Hallelujah to your name. Come on. He's here. Yeah, his presence is here. His power is here. Come on. Acknowledge his presence by saying hallelujah. Acknowledge his presence by saying thank you, Jesus. Come on. Acknowledge his presence by saying, Lord, I love you. I bless you. I magnify your name. Come on. We're going to stay right there for just a moment. Somebody just say hallelujah, Jesus. God, we bless your name. God, we glorify you. God, we lift you up. Be glorified in this place, God. Be magnified in this place, God. God, we bless you, 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 God, with everything that's in us. God, we bless you. Oh, I can't pay my bills, but I bless you. 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 My car didn't want to start this morning, but I bless you. I bless you. I bless you. I magnify your name. I glorify your name. My relationship isn't working out, but God, I bless you. Oh, God, in the midst of everything, I give you praise. I magnify you. When the lights are off, I magnify you. When I can't pay the bill, I magnify you. I give you glory for who you are, not for what you've done. God, I bless your name. God, I magnify you. Oh, God, glorify your name, Jesus. It's not about me. It's all about you. It's all about you. It's all about, I praise you on WIC. I praise you on Link Card. I praise you in the public aid office. I praise you in the unemployment office. Why? Because you're still good. It don't take a car for me to praise you. It don't take a job for me to praise you. I praise you because I have a relationship with you. I dare you to praise him for a bus card right there. Hallelujah. I dare you to praise him right now for a Link Card. Hallelujah. Look, I won't stay there, but while I'm here, I still give your name the praise. I'm just passing through to what I'm about to get to in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. Come on. Some of y'all will worship until he bless you. I dare you to give him a prequel worship right before he does it. I dare you to magnify him that's showing your faith. Come on. 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 Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, Jesus. Yeah. Yeah. Break every chain. 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 Jesus. Yeah. 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 Father, we break the chains of depression right now. Two of you are hiding your feelings this week. You're trying to act like everything is cool. But really what happened is every time you lay your head down on the pillow, you start to feel really bad. And a couple of nights you've cried and you made an excuse for it. But listen, let me tell you something. The enemy wants your mind. You cannot be ye transformed until you renew your mind. And some of you got the same mindset that you had when you first got saved. And that's why you're going through the same battles. That's why you're going through the same situations. But I decree and I declare today, if you would lift your hands and receive today, it will break every chain off of your depression right now in the name of Jesus. You got it because your mama got it. So I break generational curses in the name of Jesus. Yes, God. Yes, I bind up the stress demon right now. Some of y'all been stressing all month long, been trying to figure out how you was going to pay your rent. You were so happy that the first fell on a Saturday, so you didn't have to worry about it. But I decree and I declare by Monday, you will have an answer. God will do something on your behalf, but you've got to give him praise before it happens, because it shows him that you have faith in what he said. I don't praise you because you can pay the rent. I praise you because you're good. I praise you because you're worthy. I praise you because you're great. I praise you because you're powerful. Come on, I praise you because you're Jehovah Jireh. I praise you because you're Jehovah Nissi. I praise you because you're El Shaddai. I praise you because you're Elohim. I praise you because you're good. I won't let my situation determine my praise. Come on, somebody need to catch that thing. I said I won't let my situation determine my praise. I determine my praise. I determine my praise. I determine the level of worship. Not the money in my bank account. Not how I feel. Not what I'm thinking. But I decree and I declare a level of worship simply because God is good. Yeah. 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 Yeah, yeah, yeah. Thank you, Father. Bless your name. Glorify you. Bless your name. Father, we thank you for your presence and your power in this place even right now. God, we pray in the name of Jesus that everything that we prayed for, God, that you would begin to give it to us. God, that you would begin to meet the need. God, that you would begin to meet us at the point of our need. Oh, but God, if you don't, we'll still give you praise. For every closed door is an opportunity for you to open a window and pour us out a blessing. So thank you, Father, for closed doors in my face, because I know you're going to open up windows of heaven and pour me out a blessing that I won't have room enough to receive. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. God, we bless you. God, we magnify you and we glorify you. In Jesus' name we pray. Every heart say amen. Come on, you may have your seats. Thank you, Jesus.
Welcome to the City of Abundant Life Church. I'm Javon Campbell.
And I am Monica Reed. And this is your City News.
right, City, it's a new month, so you know I have to give you yet another challenge. Are you doing the challenges? You better be doing them challenges. Listen, we start out the year doing challenges like the tax check challenge, encourage someone everyday challenge. And so now I want to do yet another challenge. I want to encourage you to do something new each and every month to strengthen your Christian walk and also to help us grow this awesome and wonderful church. So are you ready for your June challenge? Your June challenge is very, very simple. I want you to work on marketing the church. That's it. That's all I want you to do for June. So here's your goal. We have a couple hundred flyers left, pluggers left in my office. I want you to take all those flyers by the end of this month and put them in different places. Put them at gas stations. Put them at the beauty shop. Put them wherever you go every single day. I also want you to do one more thing for me. When you're on Facebook, I want you to talk about your church. Can you do that for me? At least 3 times a week for the next month, I want you to talk about the City of Abundant Life Church. Don't just talk about, oh, it's a great place to be. Don't just say, oh, we love coming here. Listen, I want you to say something specific and let the people know how awesome this great and wonderful church is. If you can do that for me, I believe we can change our campaign 43. Well, wait a minute. It's 42 now, isn't it? Thanks for joining, D. We love you. We can change our campaign to a lower number. I believe by the end of June that we will be able to be campaign 40. Do you believe it? I believe it. So let's do it. All right, City, that's your challenge. Are you going to take it? Love you. The City of Abundant Life Church, a place where life and purpose abounds. Thank you so much for worshiping at a place that could change your life. Here at The City, we teach you how to win in everyday situations. This is a church for champions. Here at The City, we're a place of fun, a place of worship, a place of support, and a place of greatness. Why not help us grow a place now that will grow you for the rest of your life? Join the City of Abundant Life Church. We'd love to have you.
To the City of Abundant Life Church. We are so excited to have you here with us today. Here are your other announcements. Today is communion. Let us prepare our hearts and minds to receive of the Lord's Super Supper today after the word. Our outreach day was rescheduled due to the holiday. For this coming Saturday from 1 through 4 p.m. Join us as we give away cold drinks and ice cream, and our menu for sale will be barbecue, 2 sides, a drink, and we will also have delivery. Our goal is to give away 200 drinks and 200 ice creams and 200 sale dinners. So let your friends and family know that next Sunday, the city is cooking it up for the community, and we need your support. Also, if you are available this Friday, we'll be cooking the food for the outreach day. Let Pastor know if you would like to help cook. If you have donations for the outreach day, you can bring them by the church all week long. Let Pastor know. This month's challenge is to market our ministry at least 3 times a week for the entire month of June. Take some flyers and on social media, talk about our ministry and let people know about the awesome church we have. A summer calendar will be available next week on our front table. It will detail all of the planned dates for all of the summer events, so you may plan accordingly. Please make plans to attend as many of the events as you can. I'm Trevon Campbell, and this is your city news.
Amen. As he said, on next Saturday, we'll be doing an outreach day. We'll be giving away some stuff and doing some good things. So if you have some time, come on out and join us. Amen. You will notice, give me a little bit more volume on this, please. You will notice that there are no programs today. Go in. That's right. Bum, 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 bum. That's the second time he went in. You will notice that there is no programs for today. I have decided that we are doing away with programs. I'm doing away with programs because we spend a lot of time and money designing and printing the programs, and we don't use them. Most of it's my fault. I forget because we go in like we did today, and I don't want to do nothing on the program. So I decided we are doing away with programs. We will still have our order of service as it is. We're going to be changing and adding some things to it, but we're doing away with programs. We're done with that. So if you want to keep up with the announcements, if you want to keep up with things that we had in our program, you can always go on our website, thecityofabundantlife.org, and we also have an awesome board right here in the back that has all of our month's announcements on there that you can follow up with those. All right? Today, I want to do a little teaching. Cut those off for me. I want to do a little teaching. I want to talk about something that I think every Christian should consider within themselves. I want to talk about growth. And so for today, I want to teach you a little bit about growth. There's a song that we all know from back in the day, and I believe it kind of sums up how many of us feel. And so I want today to just play a quick little clip of the song.
By the bungalows, then switch to playing ding dong ditch when that gets old and too cold to hack it. Threw on a bomb.
Remember that song? I don't think they remember it. Play a little bit more.
A jacket. You can tell the ballers because they felt
y'all remember that.
If they
but
really had
somebody
money,
said that it was back in the days. When I was young, I'm not a kid anymore. I used to sit and wish I was a kid again. They used to say, I remember way back when. Yeah, y'all remember that? Y'all remember? Come on, y'all remember that? Yeah. Yeah, I remember that. I remember back in the day. Y'all remember that? Y'all know this part. And everybody say, y'all so sick, y'all so silly. Listen, ain't none of y'all saved. Cut it off before I get to cussing. So listen, the song says, back in the day, when I was young, I'm not a kid anymore, but some days I sit and wish I was a kid again. Have anybody had a time like that where you didn't have bills? Oh my God, today. Remember when mama used to cook breakfast? Oh my God, today. Jesus. Remember the pancakes with the hard edges on it? Fried in real butter from a tube. Come on, y'all ain't talking back to me. I'm talking about real breakfast. I'm talking about link sausages. Come on, that's before you was deep and stopped eating pork. You remember when you had patty sausages? You remember what I'm talking about? See, back in the days, things was a little different. Am I right about it? I remember playing it. Y'all remember it? Come on, 80s babies, get with me. Do y'all remember playing it? Freeze tag. Red light, green light. Y'all remember that? Some of y'all used to play hide and go get it. Get saved in Jesus' name. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Don't you teach them kids that game. We didn't play doctor. We played hide and go get it. Come on, y'all know it used to happen on Fridays. Don't get deep on me. Back in the days, y'all remember, some of y'all family was real black.
Y'all played dominoes. Come on, somebody. You still got a good set of dominoes at the crib. Come on, and every black family know every card game that we play in the house is based around spades. You played spades, and you had one auntie that you just could not beat because she was always cheating and drunk. Remember the 8-ounce liquor store cups? Remember those from back in the days? I remember when we used to listen to Parents Just Don't Understand. Come on, y'all. I remember when Criss Cross would make you jump. Come on. I remember when Nintendo was just an 8-bit system and the best game on it was Mario Brothers. Come on, somebody. And every now and then you played a little Duck Hunt. That's what happened. You got down and played a little Duck Hunt. Y'all remember that? I remember back in the days. I remember, yeah, this is good. Remember high top fades and pigtails? Y'all remember that? Come on, let me see if you really remember this one. I remember British Knights and Pro Wings. Come on, somebody. If you was poor, you had on Pro Wings. And if you had a little bit of money, you had British Knights. What was special about the British Knights? They lit up. Y'all had already forgot about it. They lit up when you hit the back of the foot. They used to light up. Pro Wings came out with something that light up. Did y'all know that? They lasted an hour. They were done. But it was back in the days when we was young. Back in the days when things were a little bit different. I remember being able to go to the store down the street and not have to worry about nobody trying to kill me. Do y'all remember that? I remember when we used to be able to play on the whole block. As long as you didn't leave the block, you was cool. If you crossed that street into the other block, you had a situation going on. I remember when we had to come in when the street lights was coming on. I remember back in the days. But many of us reminisce on the past and forget about the future. We remember the Nintendo. We remember the high top fades, but we forget to think about the future. Today, I want to talk to you from the topic, it's about time to grow up. It's about time to grow up. Pull up the scripture for me. 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 11. 1 Corinthians 13. Verse 11, I'm going to read the New Living Translation. And click the little box to change the screen. Calm down. Got it? There you go. Technology wasn't that crazy today, but we're going to do it anyway. When I was a child, I spoke and thought and reasoned as a child does. But when I grew up, I put away childish things. It's about time to grow up. It's okay to remember Nintendo and Duck Hunt. It's okay to remember high top fades and pigtails. It's okay to remember playing hopscotch and jumping rope. It's okay to remember those good things that we used to have when we were kids. But sometimes we reminisce on the good old days and desire to go back and stay in a certain mind frame of those days. The problem with us is, or the problem with thinking about the past is, you're not designed to stay back in the days. You're designed to always and constantly move forward. Do you believe that? Do you believe that? Y'all gotta talk back to me. This ain't a Catholic church. You have to understand that no matter what, if you keep living, you're going to get older. You can be in a coma and your birthdays will not stop. You can be in a coma for 20 years and you will still grow 20 years. Your body will still age. You'll still begin to be older. Nothing stops the progression of your life. Did y'all catch that? Nothing stops the progression of your life, but things come to change the direction of the progression. You will get older. Things will start to sag. You'll start to think differently. You'll start to feel differently. Things won't come to you like they used to. You won't be able to remember everything like you used to back in the days. I couldn't grow a high top fade today if I wanted to. Some of y'all can't get a pigtail if you wanted to, unless it was sewn in, y'all. Yeah. Some of us haven't touched a video game since they came out with the new stuff. I haven't messed with a video game since the first PlayStation. I know that's odd. Most brothers my age play video games. I haven't touched one since the first PlayStation. See, it just really wasn't my thing. Everybody around me was doing it. It was the cool thing to do, but it just wasn't my thing. And so I progressed past that. Oftentimes what happens in our lives is because the people around us are in a certain place, we desire to be in that place too. Many of my friends went and bought new video game systems because it came out and somebody else in our friendship circle had it as well. It is no matter that the situation at their home was different from the situation at my home. Maybe my mama didn't have the money to buy the game, but I still pressed to get the game because the people around me had it too. Oftentimes in life, we do that in our adult lives. We want the game that everybody else has. We want to play the same cards that everybody else plays. We want to drive the same cars that everybody else drives. We want to be grown, but see, the thing about it is that your life progresses constantly no matter what, but you have the ability to change the direction of the progression. Some of you have progressed in your thinking. Some of you have progressed in your emotions. Some of you have progressed in your career. Some of you have progressed in relationships. But some of us have not progressed in some of those areas. Some of you are still broke like you was 5 years ago. Some of you are still single like you was 2 years ago. Some of you are still trying to get to a certain place. And the focus becomes about what I don't have instead of what I do have. It's time to grow up. See, maybe you think today I'm talking to you about maturity. If you think that's what I'm talking about, you're right. It's time for us to mature in the spirit. You've been saved longer than a year. There should be some evidence of your salvation. Amen. There should be some things about you that's different than it was before you were saved. We're not designed to stay back in the day. We're designed to constantly move forward. See, while you're remembering the video games and while you're remembering all the fun stuff that we had, there was also whoopings back in the days. Them kind of whoopings that folks get arrested for now. Hangers. I got beat one time with a railroad track. Remember the railroad tracks? Yeah, not a real one, daughter. She got scared. Not one of the ones that trains be on. She said, your mama mean? A toy train track. Some of y'all got hit with pots and pan. Don't act brand new, I know. Your mama threw it right at your head. Some of us remember back in the days the good stuff, but we forget about government cheese. Come on, y'all, remember government cheese. It didn't melt for some reason. No matter how thin you sliced it, it wouldn't melt. But it made the best grilled cheese sandwiches on the planet. Somebody say amen for a government cheese sandwich. You had a curfew. You had punishments. You was poor, and you didn't have much freedom. You had to do what your mama say do when your mama say do it. Why? Because she said so. That's what back in the days was. See, sometimes we get stuck and get comfortable with old times that we forget how far we've come. See, now you got cars and apartments. And freedom. Come on, somebody say freedom. You got freedom. You are free to do what you want to do, how you want to do it, the way you want to do it, because you grown now. You good and grown now. You know you grown when you can get into the 25 and older club. Come on, somebody. You know you grown when you can make your own rules. You control your own destiny. You make your life work. So the question becomes, why then is some of our lives not working? What is your focus on? What are you trying to accomplish? What are you trying to do? Watch this. Whatever you are trying to accomplish and whatever you're trying to do in life, you need to be working towards it now. If you want to be a millionaire, you can't be a millionaire when God can't trust you with a $10 an hour job. you can't save no money when you're making $10 an hour, then how can God trust you with millions? He says if you're faithful over a few things, he will make you ruler over many. God can't trust some of us with an anthill, but we want a mountain. So we've got to change our thinking. The question I want to pose to you today is, have you grown up spiritually? Maybe you came to the city when it was New Vision. And I want to ask you, what has changed in your life since then? I've said this before, and it is true. Everybody, 100%, who has been a part of this ministry for 6 months or more has changed in some kind of way. I can personally see a tangible change in that person who's been a part of this ministry 6 months or more. And I'm going to tell you the truth. It's some folks who were here, some are still here, some are not, but I never thought that they would change. I never thought that they would become better, but they did. See, there's something about the anointing of God that changes lives. It does not come to make us sweat and run and bump and dance, but see, the anointing comes to change our lives. I wonder if there's anybody here that wants a better life than what they have today. But I need you to understand to be grateful about what you have come from. You ain't walking pigtails no more. Now you got a rap. You can go to Janine and get your hair done. God bless you. Listen, you ain't got to deal with some of the same stuff that you dealt with. Listen, I grew up in Inglewood. Inglewood was bad back then. It's worse now, but it was bad back then. I had GDs trying to get me to join the gang, and some of them was my own family members. I've come a long way. Now I talk to the GDs and I encourage them. They were trying to get me to be a part of them. Now I'm trying to get them to be a part of me. See, it's changed now. Things have changed. What am I trying to get you to understand? What's the point of what I'm saying today? The point of what I'm saying today is it's time to grow up, but you've got to realize how far that you've come in order to accept your growth. Growth hurts. Don't you know that? Growth hurts. Wear some shoes that's a size 8. And your foot grows to a size 9 and see what kind of pain you're going to go through. Have some jeans that are a size 10 and your butt then grew to a size 14 and try to squeeze into them again. You're going to have some pain. That little line around, y'all, okay. But you're going to have some pain growing up. Why? Because it hurts to grow. But is it better to stay a baby or is it better to be grown? See, a baby can't drive a car. A baby can't have his own house. A baby can't get married. A baby can't do certain things that an adult can do. Well, listen, there are things that baby Christians cannot do that grown-up Christians can. See, baby Christians falter at every little bitty thing that happens. Every time something goes on, they're breaking down. They got some type of problem. They got something going on. They need prayer. They need hands laid on them. Every single time something's going wrong, and all they need is some gas money. We'll break down over gas money. We'll break down over something minor because we're babes in Christ. But I wonder today if there's anybody that understands the importance of being grown in Christ, the one that understands being strong in who he is. Listen, I want to reset something in your mind. The church has messed us up. The church has had us to believe that in order to be a grown-up Christian, you had to speak in tongues and carry a big Bible and wear long skirts and suits to church. The church has told us that you have to come in and clap and rock and speak in tongues and shout and bump in order to be a grown Christian. But what I found out is the same people that speak in tongues, the same people with the big Bible, the same people that got all this stuff going on in church, it's full of hell outside the church and can't handle nothing when it comes their way. The minute the car breaks down, they ready to give up and kill themselves. And I'm being serious. I know Christians who have been saved for years. The car breaks down, oh, I'm going to get to work, like the CTA don't run. But we, babes in Christ, don't have the maturity to stand up to the wiles of the enemy. Can I tell you something? If the enemy is attacking you with the same stuff that he attacked you with 3 years ago, it's because you haven't grown beyond it. You still dealing with loneliness?
You're still dealing with depression. You haven't grown beyond that. And the enemy will keep on attacking you with the same stuff until you get it together. I wonder if there's anybody now that's thinking in their head, oh, that's why I keep going through this. That's why this keeps happening. That's why this keeps going on. Yes, you have not grown past a certain level. And so the enemy keeps attacking you. I hope I'm helping somebody. He keeps on attacking you at the same level because that's where you are. You know what you ought to do? You ought to go back and look at your Facebook posts from 2 years ago. If they sound like the same ones that you post now, it's time to grow up. You ought to go back and look and see the stuff that you used to say. Maybe you don't cuss as much now on your Facebook page. Thank God for that. But if you're saying the same stuff, you ain't grew much. It's something not right about that. It's something not right about a person who's 26 now and you was 23 and you're saying the same stuff. It doesn't make sense. There should be some type of growth. Watch this. Come on, Christians. Let me help you. Listen, there should be some type of growth in your thought process. The Bible says that you ought to be transformed by the renewing of your what? Mind. Not your spirit, not your church, but your mind. If you don't grow in your mind, you won't grow in your spirit. And if you don't grow in your spirit, the enemy will keep attacking you on the same level. You'll have the same head. And the same stuff will keep on going on. The reason why you date the same kind of dudes is because you haven't outgrew the same kind of dudes. The reason why you always broke 2-3 days after your paycheck is because you have not outgrown spending all your doggone money. The reason why you got so much stuff going on that's been going on, watch this, it went on with your mama. It went on with your grandmama, and you're still dealing with it. Why? Because you have not outgrown the situation. It's time to grow up.
So you understand that it's time to grow up. So here's some questions. I need you to understand if you grew up or if you haven't grown up. When you came to the church, you didn't read your word. How about now? Can you read it now? You were a certain type of person when you came here. Are you better now? Is your situation the same or worse, or have you made progress? I submit to you today that it is time for us to grow up. It's certain things you shouldn't be saying anymore. It's certain things you shouldn't be doing anymore. How did you act when you first got here? Do you still act that way now? Is something wrong if you come to church every single... Watch this. I've done this before. Listen, there are 52 Sundays in a year. You come to church 52 times a year. If you come to Bible study and you have Bible study 52 times a year, you come to church 104 days a year. That's a third of your year, the year being 365 days a year. 104 of those days, you're in church. At least a third of your life should be changed every year. That means in 3 years, your whole life should be changed. Does that make sense? It should be a 3-year process, maybe 3.5. But you've got to understand that if you go to church every single Sunday, if you go to Bible study every single Thursday, then something different should be about you. Wait a minute. If you don't go to church every single Sunday and you don't go to Bible study every single week, don't ask God to advance your life when you can't advance your praise. You can't advance your commitment. You got to start somewhere, but you got to build to something greater. Don't get stuck on the medium level. You got to grow up to a large level. Amen? Some of us doing the same stuff that we did 5 years ago. When we gonna change? How would you feel if I preached the same way I did when I started the church? It didn't get no better. How would you feel if we was at the same YMCA that we started in with broke windows? Now we got our own place. How would you feel if nothing changed in this church? Nothing was added. Nothing's grown. Nothing's become better. How would you feel? Now let's flip it. How does God feel when he's giving you so much talent, so much intelligence, so much anointing, so much strength, so much power, and nothing's changed? You're the same person you were 2 years ago. You're the same person you were last month, last year. Why? Certain things about you should change. Ask yourself, is my attitude the same as it was last year? Do I still have a negative mindset about things like I did before? Are you still crying? Are you still depressed? Do you still cuss folks out at the drop of a dime? Grow up. It's time to make some changes. You will not get anything in life cussing folk out, crying and being depressed. It's time to grow beyond those things. Amen.
There ought to be something different about you since you've been here. Something different about you since Jesus came into your life. There should be some tangible, physical, mental, and spiritual changes in you. Can I ask you, do people see your joy? Can they see the God in you? Or have you not grown up yet? The scripture says in 2 Corinthians 5, 16 through 17, so we have stopped evaluating others by what the world thinks about them. Once I mistakenly thought of Christ that way, as though he were merely a human being, how differently I think about him now. Verse 17, what this means is that those who become Christians become new persons. They are not the same anymore, for the old life is gone, a new life has begun. That's 2 Corinthians 5, 16 through 17, the New Living Translation. What that simply means is there should be some signs if you have Christ. Let me give you some signs that you haven't grown up. Here's some things that you need to understand that you haven't grown up. This is what's going on around you. You can't see people through God's eyes. When you can't see people through God's eyes, you have not grown as a Christian. You still see folks the same way that you saw them before you got saved, before you got mature. When you cannot tell that your cousin who keeps on sleeping around has some deep-rooted issues, when you cannot tell that your uncle who keeps on drinking has some deep-rooted issues that you need to be praying about, that you need to be seeking God about, when you have not seen that through God's eyes, then you have not grown up. When you can't see situations through God's eyes, everything that you see, it's always bringing you down or bringing you up. When you can't see things through God's eyes, what do I mean by that? You've got to learn how to be above all the situations around you. Whether it's good or it's bad, you've got to learn how to look down on it like God does. Why? Because you were made in God's image and in his likeness. So you've got to see people and situations through God's eyes. You haven't grown up yet if your relationship with God is still only on Sundays. Wow. Folks on your job don't even know you go to church. Folks in your family don't even know that you serve God. It's time to grow beyond that. See, when we was first Christians, we used to go and do our thing and then come to church, do our thing and then come to church. But it has to come a point where we grow beyond that. Can I help my church out real quick? I think everybody who's a part of our church is 25 or older, with the exception of one or two. If you are 25 years old, there should be some things different about you. Don't get mad at me, but I'm about to tell you the truth. Is that okay? If you are 25, you should have a bank account. You should have two. You should have a checking and a savings. They should have some money in them. You should not be cashing your check at the currency exchange. That's not what grown folks do. Now, if that's your problem, write it down. Because you need to fix it, and you need to fix it soon. Why? Because the currency exchange is charging you an arm and a leg to cash your check. You need to put your money in the bank. I know you messed up some stuff before, and now you're on the list. I get it. You can't even go to TCF. Now, when you can't go to TCF and get a bank account, that's a problem. TCF will give anybody a bank account. My dog got a bank account at TCF. His car say roof. I'm not lying. And so you got to understand that as an adult, you need to have a bank account. It's time to grow up a little bit. Amen. You need to have some money in savings. If you ain't working, I'm not talking about you. You're trying to get your life on point. That's not what I'm talking about. But you've got to advance to a certain level. It's time for you to get there. 25-year-olds, can I talk a little bit more real? Grown folks shouldn't be bored. You too grown. It's too much internet, too much Facebook, too much cable, too much everything out here to do. And you still bored? Really? And then you got the nerve to get on Facebook and put on there bored.com. Grow up! Your niece do that. Amen. It's time for us to go to another level. I'm just talking real. Grown folks. Y'all ain't gonna like me on this, but I ain't gonna get no amens. I got to say it, though. I got to. Who got my back? I need somebody to have my back. JT, no, put your hand down. You're too little. I need you to have my back. At 25... you shouldn't still be so lonely that you'll date the first cute thing that comes along. You should have grown beyond that. You should have got that out at 19, 20, 21, 22. At 25, Oh, y'all ain't gonna like me when I say it. If you still got a phone full of people that you can call when you feel in a certain kind of way, it's time to grow up. It is. It's time to grow up. It's too many STDs and KIDs out here for you to be playing games. Because KID is worse than HIV in some way if you don't want it. Come on, somebody. So you have to grow up. I'm just being real. Baby girl, woman, beautiful, wonderful woman of God who's great and wonderful and sweet and nice. If you still are moved by the attention of dudes on the street who call you little mama, if you still will give, I don't want to say it with the kids, if you will still give it up to the brother at the club who gave you a little attention, it's time to grow up. I'm just talking real. If the girl that walks down the street got a little jiggle and you about to crash your car looking at her, brothers, it's time to grow up. Glance and keep it moving. Give you a second look and keep it moving. Don't keep on you doing all this. A brother almost killed me the other day because he was checking out a girl. She was fine, but still, don't kill me because she's fine. I want to live. No point of killing yourself and you can't get to her dead. Was you gonna haunt her? You got to glance and keep it moving. It's time to grow up. Am I being real? Ooh, grown people. Ooh, y'all really not gonna like me on this one, but I got to say it. If your dinner more than 2 days a week comes in a bag with a logo on it, with a clown as their spokesperson, it's time to grow up. I see two of y'all smiling because y'all eat Wendy's. Okay, so if your bag got a white woman on it with red hair, did y'all know she was real? She really looked like the thing with the freckles and everything. If your dinner 2 nights a week or more is coming from a fast food restaurant, it's time to grow up. It's time to go home and cook. If cereal for your kids is breakfast all the time, you need to learn how to fry some swine every once in a while. You need to do so. It's time to grow up. I know y'all ain't gonna like it, but it's the truth. If it's so hard for you to get up and go to work, it's just too early. It's time to grow up. Ooh, it's time to grow up. I'm tired of that. You was late when you was 19. You gonna still be late when you 25? It's up. Listen, we always want to blame folks for what's not happening in our life. You know, the white man, he trying to hold us down, and they'll promote the white girl before they promote me, because the white girl is early and you 5 minutes late every day. Ooh, I'm preaching real good up in this church and I don't hit no amens. That's okay. I preach to a Catholic church. It don't bother me. Amen. Listen, you got to get to a place where you understand it's time to grow up. It's time to get to a certain level. Why am I telling you this? Listen, it's a sobering message today. Listen, last week we shouted and we had a good time, and I was slamming pops on the table, the same table we do communion on. Ain't that funny? But listen, you've got to understand that it's time this week to grow up. We can't keep staying where we were. You cannot ask God to give you more when he can't trust you with where you are right now. The problem with many of us is that we want more, but we won't do more. We'll stay the same way, do the same stuff, and expect God to do something new. The definition of insanity is doing the same thing over and over and over and over again, expecting a different outcome. The reason why you're in the same situation is because you think the same way and you do the same stuff. Folks who have grown up don't care who knows if they're saved and they enjoy being saved. Folks who have grown up in the spirit want to help people like never before. There should be an urge on the inside of you to do something for somebody that you don't even know. You shouldn't be able to drive past a bum and not feel something. You should not be able to have a cousin that needs your help and you not want to do something. You should want to help people like never before. Listen, when you have grown up in the spirit, you don't get mad like you used to. You just don't have a temper problem. It's time for you to grow up. If you have gotten Christ in your life, it's time for you to not have an attitude. Come on, somebody. Some of us go to church every Sunday and still got a snake attitude Monday through Saturday. God don't like ugly, just in case you don't know. It's time to grow up. You don't think like you used to when you're spiritually grown. You don't deny Christ
When you're spiritually grown, you deny yourself. You'll turn down that plate so you can be closer to him. You'll turn away from foolishness so that you can have more love and more peace and joy in your life. Listen, grown folks in the spirit understand that I can't club every Saturday night and get up for church because I'm going to be too tired. Grown folks understand that sometimes I got to make a sacrifice because the sacrifice that I make is not like the sacrifice that he made for me. The God that I serve died on a cross that I might live, and some of us are just existing and not living. Ooh, you ought to be tired of existing. You ought to be tired. You'll deny yourself for Christ. It's hard for you to hear stuff against God or the church and you not say something. When you've grown up in the spirit, you randomly want to praise. If you ain't had a random praise moment in the last 2 weeks, you probably ain't too grown in the spirit. Every once in a while, something should hit you, and you should think about the good. Listen, you should stand at the pump and complain about the number up on the screen, but thank God that you got enough money to fill up the tank. Thank God that you got enough money to make it happen. Thank God that you got enough to do what you're trying to do. Listen, I know you barely making it, but baby, you making it. You on your way to something, but listen, you got to grow up. Ooh, it's time for us to grow up. When you grown up in the spirit, you love better. You can't love like you used to love back in the day. You grown up, can't do stuff like you used to do because you've grown up. So I want to ask you today, have you grown up? Where are you in the spirit? Have you stopped at being an infant or a toddler? Or have you grown at least to a teenager? Have you become something more? Can I tell y'all something? God does not care about what you wear. God does not care about any of those minor things that we teach in church to make people feel as though they don't have it right. What God cares about is your heart. He wants you to be something greater than what you are. Listen. Don't use that as an excuse. Well, God knows my heart. He does. But you and your heart should want to be more for God. And I believe today that I'm sitting in front of a room full of people who want the more of God. Amen? I believe that you want a greater relationship with him because this church was designed to build relationships. Y'all look around. We're about to grow. It's about to happen. We're about to go to another place because we are getting to a point in life where we understand that it's not just about having good church and shouting and bumping, but it's about changing lives. You should be something greater because of where you worship. You should be something more because of where you praise, where you call a church home. If you're not better, there's a problem going on. And I'm going to tell you right now, it ain't up here because the word is being taught up in this place. And I'm not only preaching it to you, but I'm teaching it to you. I'm breaking it down to you so you can get it. It's got to get in your heart. It's got to get in your mind so that you can become what God has called you to be. Amen. Too many of us, come on baby, help me preach. It's too many of us, both of your kids is excited, they love the Lord. Too many of us are stuck, hey? Too many of us are stuck. And it's time to grow up. Now watch this. You may think today's word was a rebuke. You may think that I was trying to correct you. I'm not. I'm really encouraging you. Listen to what I'm telling you. I gave you some truth so that you can begin to measure yourself against that truth. But what I'm really saying to you is it's time to grow up. What I'm really saying to you is it's time to break out of the level that you're on. It's time to come out of the place that you've been. It's time to be something more, something greater, something higher, something bigger. It's time for something better. The God that I serve desires that you would have more. The Bible says that he has come that you may have life and that you would have it more abundantly. He doesn't want you to just exist. He wants you to have a life of abundance. What does that mean? I have enough to live on and help somebody else live on, and I still got something left because the God that I serve will supply all of my needs according to his riches and glory. The God that I serve says you can do all things through Christ that strengthens you. That's the God that I serve. The God that I serve says that you can do above all things if you would just keep him in your mind, keep him in your heart.
He is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that you could ask or think. It's according to the power that worketh in you. But baby, you've got to learn how to cut on the power. There's power in you. Come on, turn to somebody and tell them, there's power in you. There's power in you. Come on, tell somebody else on the other side, there's power in you. There's power in you too, brother. It's some power in you. It's some power in Naya. It's some power in the baby helping me preach. It's some power in you. There's some power on the inside of you. And nothing that you've gone through in life could take that power out of you. I'm preaching good to somebody. Nothing that has happened to you has taken the power of God out of you. So what? You was molested. You've got the power of God. So what? You were right. You got the power of God. So what you poke? It's okay. You got the power of God. Ooh, that power thing, it'll bless you. See, power will stop you from cussing folk out. Sometimes. Power, I'm just being honest, sometimes it won't. Sometimes the power of God will give you peace in the middle of a storm. Remember the story about the disciples on the boat in Luke? And they were on the boat, and the storm was happening, and Jesus was asleep. Jesus had peace in the middle of the storm. The Bible says that the boat was filling up with water. Jesus in the basement. He just floating. There's water in the basement of the boat, and he floating. He's still asleep. He's sleeping, and the disciples go down there and wake him up. Watch this. Let me teach y'all something, and I'm done. I promise you this is going to bless you. The storm was already happening. But Jesus was asleep. Your storm doesn't move God. Your petition to him does. So just because you're growing, going through a painful situation, just because you're in a storm, don't think that God's just going to move because he sees you in the middle of the storm. Your petition, you're waking him, you're talking to him is what wakes him. Jesus wakes up and he gets out of his sleep. It's funny. He don't ask where all this water came from. He don't ask why y'all so frantic. He deals with their faith. He says, ye of little faith, where is your faith at? Today I want to ask you, where is your faith? What is the location of your faith? Is your faith in the storm or is your faith in your God? The disciples who walked with Jesus had faith in the storm. They said, Master, the storm is about to kill us. Do you not care that we're about to die? That's them putting faith in the storm. Jesus said, where is your faith? Oh, ye of little faith, where is your faith? Is your faith in the storm or is your faith in God? And then, watch this. Did y'all catch that? He dealt with the people first, and then he dealt with the storm. He then says, peace be still. And the Bible says that the wind and the waves begin to cease at Jesus's command. Watch this. You're in the middle of a storm, and God will not end the storm to fix you. God will fix you in the storm, and then he'll fix the storm. I think you might want to catch that and write it down. He'll fix you in the storm, and then he'll fix the storm. So listen, I know you're going through something. Maybe you are dealing with some situations that don't nobody know about, but I came to encourage you today that God will fix you in the storm so that he can bring you out of the storm. He will make it better in you before he makes it better in your situation. That's why you got to grow up. Does that make sense? If you get to the level that you're supposed to get to, God will change your situation. Why? Because if he changed the situation first, then you would be too immature to handle it. So he has to fix you first in order for the situation to come to pass. Does that make sense? So that means while it's raining, that means while hell is breaking loose, that means while all this stuff is going on, you've got to grow and mature in the middle of hell. I remember watching my grandfather die. He died about a year and a half ago. And for 40 days, I sat and I watched him. I saw this man, Justin described him as like Superman. Granddaddy could do anything. Granddaddy always had money. Granddaddy always could fix stuff. Granddaddy could always do stuff. This was Granddaddy. And I saw Granddaddy drop 40 pounds in a month. That's almost a pound and a half a day. I saw the same Granddaddy couldn't get out the bed one day. He had to rock
four, and five times to just get out of the bed. This same granddaddy didn't want nobody's help to do nothing and almost fell going to sit in a chair. Same granddaddy spent the last 7-8 days of his life in bed and wouldn't take no medicine. Didn't want it. Said he didn't like how it made him feel. The days that he had those rough times, I could have been sitting there crying. I could have been sitting there frustrated. I could have been sitting there going to pieces. There were times I had my moments, but I promise you, during that time that I watched my grandfather die, the man who raised me like my child, like I was his child, like he was my father, I watched him die. I got closer to God. I had time to spend with God. I had time to reflect on me. I didn't have a lot of time with my son during that month. I didn't have a lot of time with the church. We canceled services. I had to spend time with God. He put me in a situation where death was in the other room, but he was bringing life into me. See, he was preparing me for where I am now. It didn't happen instantly, but I start to realize that watching him die brought me more life. I was not crying when he passed away. I stood in the doorway and I watched him take his last breath. He looked over at Justin. He took a deep breath and he passed away. And it was the saddest moment in my life. But at that moment, I felt such a strength because God was strengthening me throughout the process. It was hard. It was painful. And it hurt like hell. But let me tell you something. In the middle of that, I was cool. Y'all know how folks act when folks die. I had to deal with all that. We had to deal with all that. But we made it out okay. And I came right back to church after the funeral, and I preached fire down from heaven. Why? Because I still serve the same good God, even when my situation isn't that good. I need you to understand that in the middle of a situation, whatever it is that you may be in, that God can still strengthen you and make you better. Don't miss your opportunity to become better in what you're going through. Don't miss your opportunity to become who God is calling you to be just because you're going through something. So what? The thing is that you're going through. You're not stuck. You're not staying. You're going through. And God's going to bring you out. Amen. So I pray that today's word bless somebody. I pray that you were encouraged to grow in the spirit realm. I pray that you become a better Christian after today. I pray that you become a better person after today, because I believe that God is about to turn some things around in your life, but you've got to turn first. You got to pray a little more. You got to spend a little time in your word. You've got to spend a little time in worship. You've got to become more mature, because he's calling you to something greater. That's what God is leading you to. And I believe that if you would keep on moving and keep on striving, he'll do something awesome for you. Amen. Come on, let's give God a hand clap of praise. Come on, we can do better than that. Let's give God a hand clap of praise. He gave us instruction today, and he allowed us to worship and go into a great place of praise. So we thank God for that. Amen. Let's pass out the envelopes. I pray that today's word encouraged you to grow and to become something greater, become something more. On our envelopes, you will see something that says, "This is my seed. I expect a harvest in the area of." I want you to write down your prayer request on that line, whatever it may be, so that I can be praying with you. If you have a credit card, you can place the credit card in the envelope, and we will swipe it and give it back to you at the end of service. Or you can write your information down, and we will type it in.
asked all of the builders this month to give a sacrificial seed of some sort, whatever amount you choose. So this month, if you are a member, I'm asking you to partner with us and do a sacrificial seed. It is nothing magical. We need to get ahead on some finances because we got some stuff coming up that we need to do. So I'm asking you to help us and partner with us so that we can do what we need to do. Make sure you write down your prayer request on the top line. If you have your sacrificial seed today, you can check the special other box. Put the amount down there so that we'll know. Next week we'll have special envelopes for it. We're working on a number of things that I need you all to be praying about. We'll talk about those in just a second. But I want you to keep the church lifted up in prayer as we are attempting to do some new things. Father, we thank you for this time of offering. We pray right now in the name of Jesus that as we prepare these seeds, that they are prepared from our hearts. Father, we pray a 100-fold blessing on every seed sower in this building. God, those that had not to give or had not the amount that they wanted to give, God, I pray that the next time that we will be able to give, that they will be able to increase and give what they desire. God, bless their household, bless their finances, and bless them in every area that they need. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Amen. Does everybody have an opportunity to give? Everybody stretch your hand this way. God, we thank you for this offering and this tithe that are in this basket. God, we pray in the name of Jesus that everything that we need is in this basket. God, we pray a 100-fold blessing over this basket. God, we pray that those people who have sown those seeds, Father, that you would begin to bless them like never before. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Amen. We'll do our communion in just a moment. Does anybody want to be a blessing to somebody? A blessing is the opportunity in our service to bless someone with a word of encouragement, a monetary gift, or a card. We want to be a blessing to somebody on today. Shanique. Amen. Somebody else, be a blessing to somebody here on today. We want to bless somebody. Don't make me call you out. Bum, bum, bum. Monica, bless somebody. Word of encouragement. Yep, right now. Come on. Heart beating all fast. You're scared. Encourage Janine in her business. Today, daughter. Turn to Janine. I'm going to teach you how to do it if you don't know how to. Come on. Jenny, we thank God for your business, and we pray. No, it's not funny. You need to learn how to do it. Shh. You need to learn how to do it. You had long enough time to do it. We thank God for your business, and we pray God's hand over your business because I know it's hard to start something. I started something, and so I know how hard it is. So we pray God's hand. I already see increase, but I believe that God's about to do something by the end of the summer. If you stay faithful and keep moving, God's going to do something, I promise you. All right? Amen. All right, baby, bless us, bless us. She going to be in the choir. I see that happening already. She going to be singing with us. I want to be a blessing to, I don't know your name. What's your name? Candace, I want to be a blessing to you today. I want to bless you. Come here. Bring the baby with her loud self. I
Now, we need a youth church for you. Hey, y'all right? How you doing? Fix me. Snatch your hand back. I don't want to touch you no way. Hey, she's so pretty. Just want to be a blessing to you. Oh, he came up too. I ain't got nothing for you, bro. Sorry. Sorry. All right, which one now? Who is this one? This one yours? The girl. Okay, what's her name? Jody. Cool. And the little boy? Tyler. Okay. Candace, Jody, and Tyler. All right, amen. So we thank God for that. Our visitor was somebody we went to school with. Remember her? We went to school with her. So that's kind of cool. She had to creep out here to her church, but we thank God for her visiting and coming and connecting with us on today. So we thank God for that. Yes, ma'am. Mm-hmm. Sounds awesome to me. All right. Is it delicious? I don't want no, you know, if it's runny or something, I'm just going to. Oh, you went to school. Okay. Somebody made us some baked beans last time we had a little cookout. And I thought it was a cup of bean juice with like four or five beans in it. It was interesting, to say the least. So I need to just, you know, screen it, make sure it's deliciousness. So amen, we thank you, we appreciate that. That's really awesome. Y'all got some giving on y'all today. Amen. Does anybody want to become a part of the city? Damien joined us on last week. All you have to do is raise your hand. JT, we got you. Oh, I told you. Amen. Come on, y'all can do a little better than that. We got some real men in the church now. Amen. I ain't the only brother. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Where we at now? We at 41. So we got 41 more people that need to join this church, and we will be at our goal. And I believe we're going to do it by the end of the summer. I told y'all God was about to do something for this ministry. We're going somewhere. Watch this. When growth happens in this house, it happens in your house. So get ready for yours. We got a little bit of an increase. Get ready for a little bit of increase. If I'm lying, I'm flying. As you see, I'm flat on the stage. So God is about to do it. I promise you. I've seen him do it, and he's going to do it for us. Amen. Amen. We welcome you, brother. We appreciate you in this ministry. We want people who want to be real, who want to have a better relationship with God, and we want people who are trying to be something greater. We don't want nobody deep. I don't want you to get deep. If you get deep and start carrying a big Bible and all that, we're going to have a situation. I know that ain't you, but I don't want that. I want people who just love God. Put the Bible on your phone. You know, they got YouVersion now. You ain't got to have a big leather-bound Bible. I want you to keep the word in your heart and keep the word in your mind. Damien blessed me on last week. You know, Damien's a little quiet. He don't say much. But he gets on Facebook last week and told the world that he became a part of our ministry. Now, I'm going to tell you the truth. People who join church sometimes, they don't join for the right reasons. They join for various reasons. And when those people join, they barely know the name of the church, barely know where it's located. Even though all the information is online, they still can't find it. I've had people join the church and say, I joined the City of Life. Well, we weren't the City of Abundant Life then, but you know, I joined New Vision Baptist Church. No, you didn't. Daughter, what church you joined? It was Baptist. And the brother put down the whole name of the church. He tagged me in it. He invited people to come to church with him. And then somebody said, well, where is it located? And he came right back 2 seconds later, 5334 West North Avenue, let them know exactly where it is and said, come on and join. I said, that brother blessed me. And I don't know. We just became friends on Facebook like a month ago. But I bet you that's one of the highest level of likes he got. It was had about 68, 58 some likes on this thing. I said, go ahead, brother. Yes, that's what I'm talking about. And it's such an awesome thing. And that's what made me come up with this month's challenge for us to just talk about the church online, talk about the church in our lives. Because sometimes we just don't do it. We just kind of come and just do our thing. But we need to talk about it. We need to let people know about it. We need to market it. If a brother who just joined church that same day, it was literally 45 minutes he was probably driving when he did it, get somewhere safe next time, but he 45 minutes and he put it on for, and then over 68, listen, by the time I got to it, it was 38 people. I'm like, my God, it was just an hour ago and 38 people liked it, and by the end it was 68 folk, and every time they liked it I get a notification. So these people just kept coming, and I'm like, damn it, my God, dude, Jesus, here go another one every few seconds. Now, that's a blessing, because people don't have to talk about the church in a positive light.
It's plenty of Negroes who came up here who talked about the church, but it wasn't in a positive light. And so when somebody comes, I don't care who they are, and they say something positive about the ministry, if you know anything about me, I don't really care about you lifting me up. I'm not one of those type of pastors. I just want to serve. But I want you to lift up this church like crazy. And when we do that, it glorifies God. See, I don't want to be a one-man show. What y'all don't know is by the end of this summer, I'm not going to be doing nothing in this program but preaching. Y'all don't even know that. I'm not going to keep on doing everything. I've been doing it for almost 3 years. It's time for me to retire from praise and worship. If Trevon got to do it, it's time for me to retire. See, he got scared over there, turning red. You can't do it. That's okay. It's time for me to retire from doing scripture and prayer. Monica and Shanique are going to do it. They don't even know. They're going to start this month. But what they don't understand is we got to grow to another place and another level. That's why I called Monica out, and she couldn't even encourage somebody, so she got to get it together. Amen. All right, so that's what we're going to do. I'm not pushing her to make her upset or bother her. I'm pushing her because she needs to be pushed. We about to go somewhere else. It's time to grow up. Amen. It's time to get to another level, to another place, and do something more. So we're going to get there. And I promise you, all I'm going to do is sit here, lay across, look deep, and preach. That's it. That's all I'm going to do. Okay, I'm not going to look deep, but I am just going to preach because I believe that it's time for us to grow up. Our church is about to grow, and so it's time for us to grow. Amen. This is not a one-man show. This is a one-church show, and we will do what God says do. Amen. Anybody else want to join the church? I don't want to. I rushed it a little bit. Come on now. We can have you. If your baby starts screaming, I'm going to make her join. Yeah, you remember. God bless you. Amen. The doors of the church are always open. You can join at any time. Go on thecityofabundantlife.org and fill out the membership form. Okay, it's all online. So she talked. She's a member. So you got to join soon. Sorry. I told her to be quiet. See, I gave her a warning. She did it again. And so now you're a member, baby. He will put you in the choir. Go on thecityofabundantlife.org and fill out the membership form. It's under our church. You click it and then see the form to fill it out. It's a small form. We just want to make sure we have all the information on our builders. Amen. Communion is a time when we reflect on the Lord and we reflect on what he has done for us. The cracker represents his body, his flesh. It's broken so that it represents his flesh being pierced with nails. We have the juice that represents his blood. Anytime there's a covenant, there's a blood that's attached to it. And so doing communion, it makes us in communion with God, and it puts us in covenant with him. Before we take this, you always reflect on yourself from the last time that you've taken it. You take a moment and ask for forgiveness. At this church, we believe that everybody can take communion, kids included, if they're mature enough to take it. So everyone can take it. I don't want you to not take communion and say, well, I have not been living up to par. What I want you to do is pray before we take the communion. You ask God to forgive you. You ask God to strengthen you to not continue to do those things that you felt that you should not have done. And then you take the communion to be closer to him. She all right. Said, do we take the communion to be closer to him? And so that's what we want. We want to be closer to him. We want to commune with him for just a moment. Let's take a second. Bow your heads and just pray. God, we thank you for allowing us time to commune with you. God, we pray that every person that should partake of the communion on today, God, that you forgive them of any sins that they may have committed that would make them not worthy to receive of your communion. God, we take this seriously. And God, we want to let this be a representation of us communing with you. So God, we thank you and we praise you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. The white linen cloth that we have over the communion represents the cloth that was left in the grave after Jesus rose. The Bible says that he left his linen clothes there in the grave and he got up. And so we have the linen cloth that represents that. So before we take our communion, we just take a moment and reflect and pray and ask God to just make us worthy to receive. Let's just take a moment now. Let us all stand.
Do not eat your communion or drink your communion before you get back to your seat. We take it all together as a family. Amen. Starting from the back, come down this way here to the left and come on around. This is the blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus and the body. This is the blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and the body. This is the blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and the body. The blood and the body of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Take it. Get you one of those. I'll get you one of those. There you go. Get you a nice big one. All right. Body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. The blood and the body of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Blood and the body of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. The blood and the body of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. The blood and the body of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. The Bible says that at the Last Supper, Jesus came all together with his disciples. And in that Last Supper, they all broke bread and they ate together as one. Let us break bread and eat. The Bible then goes on to say that they all drank of one cup together, signifying that his covenant was about to begin with them in their lives. Let us all drink together. I'll bring your cups here. Is there anything else? Got everything in? Cool. Let us pray. God, we thank you for this time of coming together to worship and magnify your name. God, we thank you for the explosion in worship. God, we thank you for the word. God, we thank you for your power. God, we thank you for your strength. God, we thank you for your anointing. God, we thank you for breaking the chains. God, we thank you for allowing us to commune with you. God, we pray in the name of Jesus that as we exit this place, that we would never leave your presence. And Father, we pray that you would take us to our destination safely. God, let us arrive and wherever we may go, let there be peace. And if there not be peace, God, give us peace that we may be able to speak peace in that situation. God, we bless you and we love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hug somebody. Tell them that you love them.